Aye. Ladies and gentlemen, and friends of my daughter. There comes a time in every wedding reception where the man who paid for the damn thing is allowed to say a word or two about his own. And I should like to take this opportunity, drunk as I may be, to say a word or two about Brian. For I am the father of the beautiful bride over there. Now, as far as I'm concerned, my daughter could not have chosen a more delightful, charming, responsible, intelligent, wealthy, let's not deny it, well-placed young man and fertile as Brian as a husband. And therefore, I ask the question, why the bloody hell did she marry Harvey instead? Because Harvey is the sort of man that we talk about in a group of real men in a bar about his impotence. If I may use a gardening simile here, if his family may be likened to a compost heap, and I think they can, then Harvey is the most futile of them all. I think he is the sort of man people encourage to avoid. As for his family, Jesus. As for his family, they are quite simply the most intolerable, steaming herd of animals I've had the misfortune of turning my nose up to. I spit on you as I would on a rabid dog. Now, I would like to propose a toast to the caterers and to the pigeon who pooped at the groom's limousine. I can assure you, God and I had quite a laugh. And for the rest of you who are not directly related to me, you can sort of. I will entrust any of you to flush the toilet in the right way. And that is my speech.
And why is it again that you're telling me about your father's speech at your wedding? Have you forgotten that I was your maid of honor, Sandra? It's only been 8 months. And why does this look like a scenario from a movie or something? Because that is not what your father said that night.
Are you going to meddle in my tale, or are you going to let me narrate it from its very core?
Sandra, how long have I been your friend?
Since campus, say 6 years now.
And how long have I been your therapist?
What do you mean? You mean how long you have been giving me lectures like I'm some sort of your mother?
They both made you question yourself so much lately. This is new to you. You've never questioned yourself. Harvey did not turn out to be the husband you wanted, and this Elias guy has got you wrapped around his finger. You're now in a conundrum, an abusive husband and a God-sent charming man. Hence the reluctance to your tale, you are stalling.
I'm not stalling. I'm just, damn it, you're right. I may be stalling, but not in the entire context.
You tell.
I may be stalling, but not entirely. My father's speech was a beginning of an unfathomable future, something I did not anticipate. I just don't know how to do this.
No one does. It just takes a leap of faith. Narrating your life issues from strangers is hard to trust as it is, but we all end up needing it. But for you, I'm not only your therapist, but I'm also your best friend. You have experienced a tragedy. You were beaten up so badly by your husband in the event you died. For 22 seconds, Sandra, your heart stopped.
Enough!
Your husband, who is so much aware of your heart condition, continues using you as a punching bag every day of your life.
Akira, that's enough!
No being is meant to undergo such brutality.
I said I get it.
No being is supposed to be left in such situations alone.
I said I get it.
No to let me in. One finger can pick up a pebble, but one hand can move the earth.
He wasn't always like this, Harvey, you know? He was a good man. A decent man.
Tell me.
How did you know he was the one? You already know that.
I'm aware, but I still want you to tell me because in so doing we'll be able to know what we missed the first time. Tell me, what made him to be the kind of man he is now?
And that's what I've been trying to pinpoint out to you. The hate my father showed Harvey was unbearable, making him lash it all out on me.
See, that is what you tell yourself. But I believe there is more. Indulge me. How did you two meet?
Fine. It was after many seasons of his attempts to make me go out with him. He did all the pleasantries a young girl would ever dream of. But I didn't fall for it. I believed he was just another dishonest suitor who wanted to be part of my father's family. They all do ask for an introduction eventually, you know. But Harvey, he did no such thing. In fact, he did the unexpected. He poured his soul out. He approached me with his beautiful, innocent hazel eyes. I could tell he was anxious from his feet sweat, but he did well to cover it all up. He called out to me so gently, and he said,
Sandra, as we are done here, I am going to leave and I'm never coming back to your gracious presence again. Our paths will never have to cross if you so wish. We no longer have to look me in the eye and hide our connection with hostility and
fight. It's not
Sandra,
you.
Please let me finish. You no longer have to love the darkest parts of yourself that care for me in spite of the unworthiness of a man I am to you. I will be gone, and you will be free. I just want you to confess your love to me.
And in that moment, I was less conflicted. My heart was struck. I felt like kissing him. I wanted to kiss him. I knew if I kissed this man, I would be forever wed to him. So I stopped. I stopped and waited a moment longer. Then I let myself go. Say what you will about Harvey, but he's the most honest man I've ever known. I fell in love with him right there.
True love is a soul's recognition of its comfort for each other.
And what does that even mean?
According to Greek mythology, humans had four arms and four legs, and a head with two faces. Fearing their power, Zeus, the king of gods and mankind, split them into two separate heads, condemning them to spend the rest of their lives in search of their other halves.
He sounds like a complete freak.
He sure is. So I'm bound in perpetuity with an abusive husband just because we're meant to be?
Great!
Not my words, Sandra.
But you never told me how you met Ella.
There's nothing to tell.
We both know there's so much to tell.
No doubt about that. His dark eyes, his brand new swagger, his kind smile. He must have come to the picture after your ordeal at the hospital. Why are you doing this?
It's my job.
To meddle.
If need be, but therapist aside. I'm here as your friend, Sandra.
Let me in.
I find it hard to talk about all this. There are just too many fronts that are unbearable.
I understand.
But I will try.
Commendable. Take your time.
I'd say it all began the night I went to the hospital. Harvey came home drunk, as is usual.
Little bee! Little pig,
you mean?
What do you mean, what do I mean? Give me my supper, woman. Will you stop?
But you are the one to bring groceries.
Well, can't you see that I have a lot in my plate?
And what is that is a lot to you? Is it you at the bar 3 hours a day, God knows doing what? Or am I missing something essential?
How much, it, woman? Okay. I will admit, I forgot.
It's okay, just give me the
money. No. I said I will admit it. I haven't admitted it yet. Come to think of it. I don't think I will.
It's okay, just give me the
money. No. Attachment to the material is the detachment to the spiritual. Hallelujah. Why did you do this? Must I have not sufficient of obesity to be?
Do not call me that. I have been the sole provider of this house for far too long. I work harder than you, and I expect to get a little help at the very least. Now, you will go buy food or I will just...
No, wait, you are. Oh, go on. You will what? Tell me, please. What will you do? Exactly. Nothing. You will do nothing. You cannot do anything. You're a speck of dust beneath my fingernails, little pig. Your very wall of life is a gift I allow you to have. And now you have insulted a young man who is beyond your comprehension.
Have you pleased me?
In my house, you have demeaned the existence of my dominance. In my house, you have insulted my economic status. No more. You will do as I tell you, for what I say is final.
As advised with viewer's discretion, perhaps it's better to narrate the events that occurred at this juncture. He struck me with a slap at first. A cut on the lip that allowed passage of blood to stain the carpet. A fist on the stomach was what began as the epitome of an excruciating ordeal. I could have sworn I felt my insides wanting to be puked out. But alas, it all came to a stop with a few rounds of jabs on my abdomen and a final elbow blow on my head. The next thing I know is that I'm with my best friend in the hospital, right beside me, smiling, probably pleased to see that I'm alive. And a doctor coming in later to tell me that I was lucky to be alive, that during treatment, for 22 seconds, my heart stopped. That I was lucky to have gotten a new heart. But is it really my heart? After all, I got this heart from someone who just died. I never knew the former owner of this heart. This thought struck me as I lay in that hospital bed. A lot of things were on my mind that night. Why didn't I report Harvey for what he did to me? For what he has been doing to me? Everybody seems to be on board with me taking the matter to the police. What is wrong with me? But most of all, to whom did this heart belong to? This thought struck me to the core. As I lay on that hospital bed, a strong beat pumped through my chest. It was an unusual beat, accompanied with a feeling I had longed for a long time. A feeling of hope. A feeling of happiness. It was then that he arrived at the scene. This young boy with an eccentric swagger and a beautiful smile. I could tell it was telling me.
Smile, love, for the worst. Is about to do.
But he decided to stay anyway. That's what made him funny.
I believe that was because the beginning of your many dates with him.
Oh, yes. We went out for coffee turned into wine. Then wine took us to late nights without us even realizing it. But you know my favorite moments, or when we went to the movies. There was this side of him that brought out a side of me that I didn't know I had. At that moment, I was free.
My word, love. Did you see that? Did you see that? Oh, there's nothing more ravishing than a good detective film.
I don't know. The ending was a bit cliché.
Come on, what do you mean the ending was a bit cliché? Don't you love happy endings?
Happy endings are a bore. You get to expect it even before the film starts. Where is the thrill in that?
Well said, but let us look at it this way. Even though we know how the film will end, we just try to give the film an iota of doubt for the sake of entertainment, of course.
Do you know what's the most interesting thing in life?
And what is that?
Death. Because she's mysterious. She has a timeline but will not allow herself to be predictable.
Everyone is a critic now.
But it was an okay movie.
There's no winning with you, huh?
Not in the slightest.
Smart and tenacious. You are remarkable. Well, that is right, but do you know what I really love about this cop show?
Here we go.
A good interrogation scene. Breaking the suspects down. Talking quietly, but then talking too loud. Looking away and looking into the suspects' eyes. Leaving.
Ooh, that is amazing. Also, let me not forget the intensity brought out by this crazy cop coming towards the suspect and the same cop tries to subdue.
Ah, yes, the good old good cop, bad cop routine. Let's do a run scene right now.
What?
An interrogation scene. Let's reenact one right now.
You insane. We are in a restaurant. Goodness gracious.
So, as I always say, embarrassing life.
Happy life.
Exactly. Besides, there's barely anyone here. We are actually and practically alone.
Fine.
Good. I will be the overconfident suspect and you will be the crazy cop.
Question.
Ask away.
Is the suspect guilty or innocent?
There's minimal evidence and there are no witnesses, but the cop is quite sure that she has her man.
Question.
Yes.
Is the suspect smart?
Oh, the suspect is quite intelligent.
Then I will be the suspect, you be the dramatic cop.
As you wish. So tell me, what do you want the scenario to be?
Where did this man come from? How did he even know my favorite genre is detective films? He blessed me. He looked through my eyes and got me. He makes me feel young again. He makes me feel happy. So, here's the deal.
Yes.
I killed my husband.
I mean, I was just expecting petty theft or something of that sort.
So, I killed my husband after he discovered I'd been embezzling funds from his accounts. Part of the evidence to build your case is that I'm a shopaholic with no source of income. Let's say the murder weapon is a knife, 3 stabs in the chest and 1 in the abdomen. So I covered it all up by dumping the body, which you clearly found, but no murder weapon. Just testimonies from the neighbors saying that our marriage was never a piece of heaven. Mind you, I might be a social worker.
Why do you die?
Shall we?
Yes, we shall.
You lie.
Let's start from the beginning. According to your marriage and your neighbors, it was a failing kind.
I take it that you couldn't shut when here. Yeah. Well, our marriage had its ups and downs, as all marriages should be.
And why is that, if I may ask?
Your job is to ask. Well, my husband was an extravagant participant in his extracurricular activities, if you know what I mean. When I found out, he decided not to take it well with me. He didn't take it with dignity, actually.
What do you mean?
He cried, like a pathetic of a child.
So you started stealing from him, and then you killed him, because he wasn't a man of your satisfaction?
Your words, detective, not mine.
So, what happened next?
What happened next is that he dropped his balls and never turned back to get them. He became more pathetic. He wanted us to renew our vows. What's wrong with what I said the first time? What's wrong with I do? I did, didn't I?
Miss Sandra, if you would please just...
I kept my vows. He did not. It should not be my fault if he decided to pursue his own issues with infidelity.
Miss Sandra, if you would please
just... And he's not ashamed coming to me crying with tears on his cheeks. What's wrong with our African men? Where are our true, strong, rough African men that our mothers promised us? Where are the so-called generation of African men?
That is enough! This typical feminist shit of a marital catharsis is of no essence to my time. So what if your husband cheated on you? Do men and dogs live with it? Or you sit here with your expensive clothes and your adopted English with no remorse at all about your husband's death, and you wonder why you're not my suspect. You think that intimidates me, but you're quite wrong. You never loved your husband. You were just there for the money. And I'm suspecting he realized that and decided to look for other lady options. So you stole from him and then you killed him.
Wow,
have
you seen
women
and the dramatic?
Ah! I
didn't
tell you!
I did! I just did! Healthy competition. Mercy is disrespect.
Is that a confession I hear?
I did what I had to survive.
I want you to say the words of this conversation is over.
You do not understand what that man did to me. I am an intelligent woman. He was a weak bully. I did the world a favor.
I just want you to say the words. Just say it. Say the words.
I am a woman fit for this century. I'm not here to all my female comrades.
I am going to count to three and there will not be a four.
I am a goddess among your mates.
One.
I am of mixed religion, therefore I am godless and answer to no one.
Two.
I was adopted by Satan herself before I was returned out of fear of mutiny.
Three.
I am who I am because I choose to be with no consent of a man. I confess to killing that weakness of a man.
Thank you.
Then I was in love. Totally a different thing.
There are some similarities, but even though, why deny it?
Because it's not right.
My husband, fat.
I'm sorry.
Percussion noise of fight. But I've never told you. And I don't think I ever will. Because I'm in love with you. And I love you. You know, people call these things imperfections. But they're not. You're not perfect, and so is Elias. The question is whether you two are perfect for each other. That is where intimacy comes in.
Perhaps.
Why haven't I met Elias yet?
Your talent for gossip is a renowned activity amongst the trusted area.
Well, did I learn from the rest? I believe our time is up.
But I don't want to go home.
Yet you have to.
Yet I have to. When I was in surgery for my weak heart, they told me it was worn out. So you very well know I had to get a heart transplant. They took my heart out and threw it away. It felt weird, like I'd lost a part of myself. They told me it was a miracle to be alive, but I did not see it. I just felt half dead.
It must have been hard.
It was, and it still is. I have been feeling bad most of my life since then. Until he came along and I began to feel more alive. I'm not going to mend my heart and give it to someone else to break it. I must end it with my husband or I will kill myself.
Okay, no need for dramatics. I believe you should be touching me.
There are worse things than dying.
What's worse than dying?
Living like this.
There is no beer. You see this? This is my therapist. The best thing is the business.
Javi, I'm leaving you.
Excuse me?
I'm in love with someone else.
A lot.
Ah yes, of course. Akira, that woman. I told you, Kintai.
My best friend is a demented woman.
Why?
Oh, look at all these crazy ideas she has implanted on you.
Avi, she did nothing of the sort. She just helped me realize what I've been ignoring all along. Now, out of my
head. No!
Let me go!
Santa, no!
Move! I said move!
As a divorced feminist,
I refuse to say that you hate me better than me.
Now, I'm going to leave. Not because you told me, but because I have to get my mind off you at the bar. I'm coming back to my house, and I expect to find you here when I'm back. In heaven, there is no beer.
When the doctor said, that your survival was nothing but a miracle. They weren't lying, Sandra. You're burying his heart.
I'm trying to say, I'm burying his heart. No, this cannot be possible.
I'm afraid it is.
This cannot be real.
I don't know what to tell you, but this here, psychologically, can be diagnosed as an underlying delusional disorder. Or schizophrenia triggered by trauma, but this here, this is not textbook at all. You can stay at my place. Let's go.
Stop, get out of here. What is that last doing in my house? Open this door.
Sandra, where are you going?
Little pig, open this door this instant.
Away from depression. And now I cannot have him. He made me happy, and I loved him. And now I cannot have him. If I cannot have him, then that man out there will not have me. I must end him.
Then you become a felon. Surely you do not want this, Sandra. Please just give me the knife. Sandra, please.
Little pig, open this door.
Do not call me that.
Open the door.
I can't, Akira. I must end this.
No, you must not.
I will have.
I agree that he deserves every suffering, but not into your hands. But not in your hands. Please, just put that knife.
I will puff.
Sandra, please.
And I will destroy you.
I can't, Akira. I must kill
no,
this man. And I will kill myself.
No, you do that. He wins.
Nonetheless, he still will help me.
No.
Stop.
What is wrong with the both of you?
Why are you on the floor crying?
Sandra! Oh my God! Sandra, do something!